You might live here, or you might be selling your house, moving to a new house. It's spanning the state. I'm Brian Noonan. So if you are planning on buying or selling a home anytime soon, you might want to do a little bit of homework, because a major rule change to the residential real estate market went into effect in August, just a couple weeks ago. Change is going to affect how real estate agents are paid. How's this going to affect you, whether you're looking for your first home, a new home, you're trying to sell your home? Well, Angela Kallay of Benefit Realty in Franklin is here, and she's going to answer those questions. Thanks for coming in, Angela. I appreciate it.
Absolutely. Thank you for the invitation. I appreciate the opportunity.
So what brought this around? There was some sort of lawsuit, correct?
There was. There was a couple lawsuits in other states that were brought against the National Association of Realtors.
Okay.
And in an effort to settle those lawsuits, they settled and came to a couple terms that they agreed upon. And because the National Association of Realtors is all of the members throughout the country, even though in the state of Wisconsin, some of these things were not going on and okay. we weren't subject to them, we are still needing to follow the settlement agreement.
And what is the agreement?
So there's two big changes that you will see. One for buyers, not the biggest thing. You're going to be asked to sign a form before you see a property. So in the past, you called an agent up, you want to take a look at a property, you meet them at the house, you go through.
Right.
You can no longer do that without signing a pre-agency showing form.
Really?
And that's really a consumer protection. A lot of this is about commission transparency and the transparency around fees and what brokers are being paid and by whom.
Okay.
So that form is going to educate buyers of the different types of agency relationships they can have with the agent that they choose to work with.
Okay.
And if there's any fees involved with them actually showing or being shown the property from the agent that they're working with.
Okay. So let's just say, because that it sounds similar except for the paperwork, but before, like you said, if you were my agent and I said, hey, Angela, or I called somebody and said, I want to see this house, we'd just show up and right. then we'd look. Now, it could be the seller's realtor who was showing me that house,
mm-hmm.
or it could be my realtor that I'm working with. What now are they looking at? If I'm that buyer and mm-hmm. I'm going into a house, who am I contacting? Does it change how I call or how I see the house?
Buyers have different reasons that they might call a listing agent who has the house listed as opposed to an agent who is representing them. I mean, as a realtor, I've been doing this for almost 20 years. My recommendation would be to interview realtors and talk to them and see who you enjoy working with. Maybe it was a referral from somebody. Who do you have good communication with? And really go through that interview process with an agent before deciding who to work with. But in this pre-agency time, it's called, okay. before you've chosen an agent, you might want to call the listing agent and see maybe if that's somebody you want to work with. You might just call somebody that your mom or your friend used and get an idea of who that is. But that's that pre-agency time where you can really kind of try to decide who you want to work with.
Now, you mentioned consumer protection is part of this deal. The old way of thinking was, oh, you want to have your separate realtor. You don't want to be the buyer using the seller's realtor. Does this change that, or is that still a
So good. That opinion might change depending okay. on who you ask. I always think it's best for a buyer to enter into a buyer agency relationship with an mm-hmm. agent that allows that agent to represent their best interests when it comes to writing an offer and negotiating an offer. Without that buyer agency agreement, you will not have somebody advocating on your behalf, which in this type of transaction, a lot of money involved, a lot of investment. Yeah. It's important to have somebody working for you.
So for the buyers, they're going to have to fill out and sign one of these forms every property they view, correct?
No.
With each,
okay. That's a good question. That is going to be per agent. So if they're seeing the house for the first time with one agent, they sign it the first time they see a property with that agent. But if they see a property with another agent, that agent's going to ask them to sign
okay.
that form.
But if I've made my decision and you're my agent, I sign it once with you, and then you can show me as many properties as we need to see without it being signed again.
We can, but you would need to decide as a buyer before you start negotiating the terms of a purchase if you're going to have that buyer agency agreement in place or not.
Oh, so
there could be two forms involved on what you decide.
All right. Yeah. So what about the seller? You know, I mentioned I'm going through this with my mom. Yeah. And we had talked to the realtor, I think, a week before the changes went into effect. And she was like, okay, well, this is not really going to affect you too much. But if I'm going to sell it starting now, like if I was going to list it, what's the seller got to go through?
Well, so the listing contract is almost the same as it was before. We've been really well protected in Wisconsin. Our association does a wonderful job of protecting realtors and consumers. But what's different, and this is the national change, that now as realtors, in the past, we would be able to indicate what cooperating broker commission the seller is willing to offer in the MLS. So MLS is that database that we use, and in such as realtors, we have an agreement as being members of the MLS that we are sharing our properties with all of the other members. And in turn, we're telling you, if you bring your buyer to this property and you have a successful closing, this is the amount of commission out of that total commission that my seller is paying that you are going to be compensated for bringing your buyer. We can't do that anymore.
Oh, really?
Correct.
What was the purpose of that change?
Transparency. It's very hard. It's hard as a realtor for me to, because it worked really well.
I was going to say, it would seem like an incentive where, okay, if I know as a buyer's realtor, I'm going to get X percentage of the thing. Does it make me show that house a little more? Maybe. Yeah.
You're right on. It's a marketing tool.
Yeah.
And it's always been a marketing tool to realtors, right?
Right.
So when a seller is entering into a listing agreement with me and they're saying, this is the total commission that I'm going to pay. And then there's a disclosure in that listing contract that of that total commission, this is the amount of your commission that you can offer to the buyer's broker. And we're advertising that. We're saying, please come and show and sell my listings. Yeah. Bring your buyers. And now we can't do that, not through the MLS. And that's the tool that we've always used. So it could still definitely be in the seller's best interest to offer that, but we can no longer use the MLS to market it.
Okay.
So now what we're looking at is using that compensation as a marketing tool to buyers. Because if sellers are not going to choose now to split that commission and they only want to pay the agent who's representing them. I mean, I talk to people now who are either new to the market, they've never sold a home before, or they're new to real estate in general. Maybe they're a new licensee and they say, well, this just makes more sense. Are you telling me that that in the past the seller always paid the buyer's agent too? This makes more sense than that. Why wouldn't it have always been that way?
Right.
Well, because sellers want to sell their house.
Yes.
So they want to market their house to other agents to show and sell it. Right. So now sellers would use that offer of compensation to their buyer's agent as a marketing tool to buyers instead. Because without that offer of compensation, the buyer is now paying that realtor's fee.
Okay. So will it, do you think, and I know you're not a fortune teller, you're a realtor, do you think it'll become an equitable thing, or is there going to be a huge change in how commissions are paid based on, you know, that, well, I don't have to do it anymore.
Yeah.
I don't want to give commission. I'll give Angela my commission because she sold my house, tell the other people to pound sand.
Yeah, I mean, I'm excited to find out.
Yeah.
I mean, I think at the end of the day, the seller is worried about the bottom line. Yep. So if they get a great offer and that buyer is asking for their compensation to be paid for by the seller, and it's still a better offer than the other offers they have, why wouldn't they?
Yeah.
You know, they want the buyer to buy their house. And if that's the tool that makes that happen, they may be agreeable to that.
As a seller's realtor, would that, is there going to be a change in those? Because if, like you said, I used to pay, say, 8% was my. Well, I knew that 8%, I was leaving it up to the two realtors to divvy it up amongst themselves. Now, am I still going to be paying 8% and then 8% to the buyer's realtor? Or how is that going to
work? Well, that's a conversation to have with your listing agent.
Okay.
So there are so many different models out there and so many options for sellers.
Yeah.
Again, interview a lot of agents, see who's going to have the best fit for you and who some agents might recommend that you still have that offer of compensation. And another agent might recommend based on that seller's position don't offer compensation. Yeah. Just see what the buyer brings. Maybe okay. based on the price point, they think the buyer for their home will have the capital yeah. to pay their own realtor. Based on the price point of their home, if they think that maybe a first-time home buyer, small down payment, they don't have the funds to also cover their realtor's commission, it might be more advantageous for them to offer that up front, to, again, to market to the buyers that, hey, don't worry about it. We've got you covered. Come and buy my house.
Well, I'm glad you brought up first-time home buyers, because some of the things I've read that were con to this whole issue was that it might hurt first-time home buyers. One, how could it do that? And two, do you think that's going to happen?
That was my biggest fear when this first started. If you look back, I did a video, I think, with when this was first announced. And my first thing was, man, this is going to suck for first-time homebuyers. Yeah. And that's because you, when you're saving up for your first home, you're saving up for all of those out-of-pocket expenses. You've got your closing costs, your inspection, your appraisal, your down payment, which could be sizable or it could be minimal, but that's subjective. A minimal down payment to one person might be everything that they've worked sure. so hard, and now on top of it, they're going to have to pay their agent.
Yeah.
So that's it. It's a hurdle, and it I think hurts their negotiating power coming in as a first-time home buyer. If you are now competing with somebody who is either a cash buyer, has a large down payment, or just has more funds to pay their realtor, you might have had equal offers before, but now this yeah. person's paying their agent, and you have to ask the seller to pay your agent. That's going to hurt your offer. So,
well, that's one more thing to make first-time home buying a challenge.
Yeah, but that's what you got realtors for. So.
Exactly. Well, speaking of that, how do people get a hold of you, Angela?
Benefit-realty.com. Okay. Myself and our other trusted agents, we cover all of southeastern Wisconsin and part of Madison as well.
Perfect. Well, thanks for coming in and clearing this up. It's still a little bit confusing, but I was never good with numbers anyway.
Yeah. So I tried my best.
No, you
it is confusing.
You cleared it up for me. I'm like, oh boy. But thank you, Angela Kallay, Benefit Realty. Check them out online if you're buying, if you're selling, whatever it is, call Angela. Thanks for being here. I appreciate
it. Thank you.
All right, we'll do more after this. It's